earthquakes happen every day. They're common natural events on our Earth, and they're fascinating. But there's so much to learn about these moving quakes, and so many people still have questions.
What is an earthquake? How often do they happen? Why do you feel shaking? And what do I do when I feel an earthquake?
Understanding earthquakes is the first step, and being prepared is the second. So first, let's get started with the science of what an earthquake actually is.
My name is Jake Walter, and I'm a seismologist, which means I get to study earthquakes. To explain what an earthquake is, first we have to look at the uppermost layer right here. You see, the Earth consists of mainly molten rocks, and at the surface, the crust of the Earth is broken up in chunks called plates. Where that crust is broken up, faults form, where the rocks want to move in opposing directions, but it's held fast by friction. When forces that drive tectonic plate motion overcome friction, that fault slips. Now, the Earth is elastic, much like a rubber band, and when faults slip, it can send energy throughout the Earth. Now, when earthquakes are big, they can create very large waves that can shake the ground violently. If a house or a school is in the way, it will shake and can lead to damage that might lead to an injury from something falling. This can happen in just a matter of seconds, so you need to move quickly. That's why it's important to know what to do when you feel an earthquake so that you can take immediate action and keep yourself safe.
Okay, so we're gonna do a test. Are you guys ready? Okay, so let's pretend that an earthquake is happening right now. What would you guys do if that happened?
Run.
Okay, that's a good one.
I'm not sure.
That's perfectly fine. So, when an earthquake happens, there's three steps that you need to know to be prepared. Drop, cover, and hold on. So, let's pretend an earthquake is happening and you feel it right now. So what do? First, you drop. Go ahead, you guys can do it along while I explain. Wherever you are when the earthquake begins, drop down to your hands and knees. Step two is cover. Cover your head and your neck with your arms to protect against any falling objects or debris. And step three is hold on. Use one hand to hold onto your desk and use the other hand to continue to protect your head and your neck. And be ready to move just in case your desk or your table shifts around. So that's it. Those are the steps that you need to be able to do in an instant. Drop, cover, and hold on. And those steps, they work at home as well. So now, all you have to do is just practice, so that way you can immediately respond and do those steps just in case an earthquake happens.
But are you supposed to get into a doorway when there's an earthquake?
No, actually not. A lot of people think so, but the safest response is the drop, cover, and hold on method.
Can't you just run away from an earthquake?
Earthquakes happen quickly. You can't outrun them, so it's best to stay put and take cover.
Don't earthquakes happen only like once every couple years?
Earthquakes actually happen quite often. We detect many that can't be felt by people every day.
Do I need to be scared?
People all across Oklahoma are monitoring earthquakes to learn more about them every day, as well as to help us learn how to build safer buildings and be prepared. If you know to drop, take cover, and hold on, you can rest assured you have a plan and know what to do. Earthquakes are a natural, fascinating part of our world. When you understand how they work, it's amazing to realize how connected our world is. When earthquakes do happen, though, it's important you know what to do. Being prepared to drop, cover, and hold on is important. And practicing these often will help keep us all safe in the event one occurs. Practice these steps, stay safe, and keep learning. This is only the start to understanding the fascinating world of earthquakes.